My Sunday mornings often consist of curling up with my blanket, drinking my tea du jour, and catching up on some of my favorite bloggers. One of my favorite blogs is by Andrew James, the Scottish beauty blogger behind Beauty and the Boy. He does these fact-based reviews of popular cosmetic products. He's got a lot of energy, flair, and he'll strip down a product and tell you exactly what he thinks. He recently did a string of posts on sunscreens. I reached out to Andrew and asked him if I could do a little ditty on how sunscreen works so that you guys can better understand his recommendations. He said yes. So thanks to Beauty and the Boy, we're going to do a quick rundown on some of his sunscreen recommendations. Sunlight is made of packets of energy called photons. They can be broken down into different wavelengths, but when it comes to sunscreens, there are two we're really interested in, UVA and UVB. Although we can't see them, they have a big impact on our skin. UVB wavelengths penetrate the upper layer of skin and are mostly responsible for burning. UVA is more abundant, and because it can penetrate the deeper layers of the skin, it's said to mostly affect aging, though both types of rays can cause skin cancer. Now, some UV is essential for bone health. If you want to know more about that, you can see my vitamin D video right here. But too much UV can be problematic. Most of the UV that hits our skin is absorbed by melanin, the color pigment that also gives our skin color. Occasionally, though, UV will slip past the protective melanin and it will strike DNA directly, changing its shape and function. Even when melanin absorbs UV, sometimes it produces a reactive oxygen atom. It crashes through and it damages all sorts of structural components in our bodies, like lipids, proteins, and DNA. Hulk smash! In fact, this gorgeous beach tan, sported by this Instagram model, is an unhappy example of direct DNA damage. By the time you have a tan, the damage to your skin is already done. To prevent damage, we wear sunscreen. This is why Andrew is always preaching and teaching about sunscreen, sunscreen, sunscreen. Driving in your car, wear sunscreen. Dark skin, sunscreen. Chilling in the shade, too bad, wear sunscreen. All right. You get the point. So we know it's important, but how does it protect us from UV rays? Inside the bottle of this opaque cream are ingredients called UV filters. These are molecules that help reduce the amount of UV rays that reach our skin's surface. You've probably heard Andrew mention some of them, but if they don't sound familiar, it's because different filters are available in different countries. In the EU, there are 27 filters. In the US, there are 16, of which I see about 8 used reliably. Historically, UV filters can be divided into two categories, physical and chemical. Sometimes they're also called mineral and synthetic, inorganic and organic, or heaven or hell if you're the type that fears the word chemical. Please, don't go thinking one is better than the other just because one label sounds like it comes from the rocks found in nature, while the other sounds like it comes from a lab. They're all chemical, and they all have advantages and disadvantages. Chemical filters are molecules like avobenzone, octisalate, octacrylene, octopus, just kidding. Like little energy converters, these filters absorb UV light and convert it to heat. Some chemical filters can be more reactive, particularly for those with allergies or sensitive skin. An example of this is avobenzone, which becomes more irritating as it breaks down through photodegradation, though manufacturers now have photostabilizers to prevent this from happening. Physical sunscreens are molecules like zinc oxide and titanium dioxide. They can leave a white cast on skin, so manufacturers often micronize them to fine particles to make them more transparent. Though you may have been told that they reflect UV light from skin, Andrew points out this is actually a myth. What? Didn't realize you'd be learning so much today, did ya? These micronized molecules reflect less than 5% of the UV spectrum. So contrary to popular belief, they protect you in the same way organic filters do, through absorption. Despite this division in the makeup of UV filters, the reality is that many sunscreen makers will use a whole mix of UV filters since they're effective at different wavelengths and they want to provide protection against the whole range of UV. This is why all of Andrew's top 5 favorite sunscreens include broad spectrum protection. When you see this on the label, it means the sunscreen is formulated to protect for both UVA and UVB. That's important because SPF only measures UVB protection, so it's only half the equation. On top of that, it's important to remember they're UV filters, not UV blockers. So small amounts of UV radiation still get onto skin. An SPF of 15 filters out about 93% of UVB rays. An SPF of 30 filters out 97%. An SPF of 50 filters out 98%. If you have an SPF of 100, you're filtering out 99% of UV rays. But just remember, no matter how high the SPF, you'll never block out 100% of UV. Slathering yourself with sunscreen forms a barrier that absorbs or reflects UV light before it reaches your melanin, DNA, and other molecules deeper in the skin. If you're looking at your skin with a microscope, you would see a topographical map of peaks and valleys. Sunscreen needs time to settle and cover all that terrain. The more evenly it's applied, the better the coverage you get. This is why you're encouraged to apply sunscreen 20 minutes before you go outside. It's so that it can form a film. And of course, sunscreen doesn't last forever. Just like we have to reapply our lipstick or our foundation because it comes off over the course of a day, sweat, removing our clothing, swimming, holding the phone to our face, all of these activities also remove sunscreen from our skin. How often you should reapply, that can differ from person to person and the type and amount of activity in your day. But experts agree on one thing, you're probably not reapplying it enough. Andrew's general recommendation is applying sunscreen every 2 hours if we're outdoors, and he must be on the right track because the American Academy of Dermatology agrees. Go Andrew. Not only are we not using enough sunscreen, but we're not applying enough onto our skin. A study in 2002 shows a majority of people apply between a quarter to half the recommended amounts. One of my favorite things about Andrew's reviews is that he's always covering all the new sunscreen formulations. For example, he recently did a post on powdered sunscreen. It's great for when you have to apply sunscreen over makeup, which is difficult to do with a cream, right? But he also made it clear that it works best when you have a primary sunscreen underneath. This is because loose powders are loose, so they come off the skin a lot quicker than a cream. Through him, I also learned about transparent sunscreens. So I took a look at the list of ingredients to see how they worked. Traditional sunscreen creams use some filters that are dissolved in water and some that are dissolved in oil. When they get mixed together, they form an emulsion, which is one of the reasons they are creamy white. In these new transparent products, all the UV filters are dissolved into just one or the other. Just oil or just water. This is called a single phase because it's not a mixture. In one of his posts, he also mentions Clinique Solar Smart, which is one of a number of sunscreens that are offering antioxidants in their formulations. Remember when we talked about reactive oxygen atoms that act like snipers and take out important structures in the body? These antioxidant ingredients could neutralize free radicals and provide a secondary measure of UV protection. So if you haven't seen his blog, you should totally check it out. I'll put a link to it in the description, and maybe I'll be reading one of your comments on his blog next Sunday morning. As always, don't forget to like, subscribe, click that notification button, and have my URL tattooed on your forearm. Thanks for watching.